Welcome to the literacy class, children. So in today's class, we are going to discuss about the process of writing, or we can call it as five stages of writing. So many of you have got a little aversion towards writing, like everybody has that, you know, when a topic is given, you don't know how to start it, you have starting troubles, and you don't get ideas to write much. So to make your work easy, this, you know, if you follow this process of writing, if you follow these five stages of writing, it will be very easy for you. So till grade 2, you were just following one stage of writing, because you were in grade 2. You just had followed one or two stages of writing. But this year, we need to follow all the stages of writing. So let us discuss what are those five stages. So as discussed before, these are the five stages of writing, or we call it as a writing process. So the first stage is pre-writing, the second one is drafting, next one is revising, editing and publishing. So in grade 2, what you were doing is, you did only till pre-writing and drafting, because we were in virtual classes, we couldn't do the revision, editing and publishing part properly. Okay, but this year we won't consider this pandemic as a barrier for that. We will do it through Google Classrooms. Okay, so the only thing I request you to do is, whenever I make any correction to your writing works, just post it back so that you can correct it again and publish it. Okay, so I'll describe one by one. So in the first picture, you can see the first stage is pre-writing. So before you write something, when a topic is given to you, you think, right? You cannot directly write the passage. You cannot directly publish it, because there would be mistakes in that, or there are chances that you miss out some important points, or, you know, everything is possible when you write. You may tend to miss, you know, the point that you wanted to include, but later on you forgot to add it. It can be anything, or the structure of the writing is not proper. It follows certain structure, right? Every passage has got those three structure. So pre-writing is nothing but where you think about that topic again and again, and you make a mind map out of it, or you brainstorm it. Like in the definition they have given, pre-writing means brainstorm ideas and organize your topic. So think what you want to write. Okay, so tips for the writer. So here in this image, they have given the tips also. So to pre-write, what you need to do is think about what you want to say. Talk about your ideas with a friend to find a main idea. Use a list or web to organize your ideas. So pre-writing is, like they have told us, it is a form of brainstorming and thinking. So when you think also, you are not jotting it down somewhere, but there are chances that you miss out few points, as I told you before. So to avoid that, pre-writing has got a certain kinds of, different kinds of graphic organizer, where you can jot down all those points, those important details about a topic, so that later on when you make it into a passage or write it in a follow a drafting process for that, it will be very easy for you. So pre-writing is nothing but think what you have to write about the topic, collect the points from wherever you want, because research work here also, you need to apply your researching, right? You have to apply your researching skills. So what you have to do is, you can collect your points, you can collect your opinion, you can discuss with people, you can do whatever you want, but your points should be in the form of a pre-writing. This is not the stage where you just write a paragraph, okay? That is not the stage. You are just jotting it down, what you want to write. That is the first stage. Next stage is, you are creating a rough copy of your writing. Once you have done the pre-writing, you feel that, okay, I have collected the points that I want to write. Now I can make it into a passage or a paragraph. You are going to write it as a paragraph. That stage is called as drafting. That is a rough work. It's not a main work. That is just a rough work. So here, what you have to do is, the tips are, write your ideas in order. So to avoid confusions, write it in order. Read your work out aloud and note places where you stumble. Ask a friend for his or her feedback. So mainly, you need to read aloud your passage, because that is when you understand whether your passage is in the right direction or not. Because there are times when we miss out grammars in that may be a careless mistake. Okay, so to avoid that, you can read aloud that passage, or if someone is there near you, you can ask them to read it for you, or you can ask his or her feedback, because feedbacks, these feedback plays an important role in any activity that you do, because that is where, that is a stage where you can correct yourselves or you can add some more details into that. So whenever you draft it, you follow all these three things. And the next stage is revising. So you have done the pre-writing, you have collected the points, you have put those points in the form of a paragraph. The next stage, that is the third stage, is revising. So as the name suggests, it is revising. You're checking it for any mistakes. So improve your writing. It's nothing but the definition of revising is improve your writing. Try out different beginnings and endings. So once you start reading your passage, once you have drafted your passage, you read it and you may find it out, no, this is not fine, this is not the way I wanted to start. So you can change it. So in revision, you do all these things, the corrections, all these corrections you are doing. So try out different beginnings and endings, use quotes or add dialogues. So wherever necessary, for example, if you are writing an essay, a motivating essay or a speech, something you are writing, you are preparing. So you can add quotes that state some examples, or you can add dialogues. If you are writing a big story, you have to add dialogues. So adding a dialogue or a quote gives richness to that text, piece of writing. Piece of writing is nothing but the passage. Next is add detail to develop important parts. So adding more and more of details. Whenever I ask you to write something, keep this thing in mind. Whenever you write something, let it be anything. Let it be a story, let it be opinion writing, let it be a descriptive writing. Support your passage with lots and lots of examples. So what happens is once you publish your writing, someone else is reading, that person understands your passage very clearly because you have supported your, you know, writing with lots and lots of examples. So these are the stages that you need to do when you are doing the revising part. The next part is editing. Now you have done, you have thought, okay, whatever I had to change, I have changed. Now it is fine. At that point, you need to proofread your work. This is where you find out your mistakes and you correct it. So you have to make sure you have complete sentences. This is where you have to check your grammar, capitalization, and vocabulary, everything, punctuation, everything you need to correct, because it's not a passage that you are going to read. It's a passage someone else is going to read. So it should be it should be proper. Okay. So you have to make sure everything is right. The structure of the sentence is correct. The paragraph has got three parts. I have told you already, that is topic sentence, body sentence, and closing sentence. So topic sentence always talks about the introduction part about the topic. That is, if you are writing about an animal, it should talk about that animal, right? The introduction. Then in the body part, you need to describe about those animals or whatever, what topic you are choosing, about that you need to describe. You have to give examples. You can give reasons. It depends upon the genre of writing. The last is the closing paragraph, that is the closing sentence, where you will put your opinion there, what you think about that topic, whether you like it, if it is a food, if it is something else, whether you like it or not, all those things. Yes, it is good or bad, everything, your opinion should be in the closing sentence. So that is the structure of a passage, right? So you need to check all this in the editing, not only for the spellings or punctuations or grammar, you should check the organized way, whether it is in an organized way or not. So editing, how you can do is, you can reread it again and again to find out any mistakes are there. Ask a friend to proofread your work. So whenever you write, there are chances that you make a careless mistake and you are unable to find it out. You can give it to other people also, so that they can jot down your mistakes. Okay, they can, you know, they will correct your mistakes. Next is publishing. This is the final stage in writing. You have done pre-writing, drafting, revising, editing, and if you feel that yes, I am ready with my passage, that is the place where you create your final copy. Here you avoid all the mistakes that you have made in the previous parts of writing or the process of writing. You correct all your mistakes and you write a new passage. New passage in the sense, not the new information, the same passage, but with all the corrections. Okay, so type your writing or copy it neatly onto a new paper. If you have written, see, all this pre-writing, drafting is okay. Once the drafting is done, this revising and editing will make that paper very messy, because you rub and you write it again and again and again. So you need to take a new paper, new piece of paper, and write this publishing part. So think of an interesting title. Now, whenever you write a passage, it's very important that you give a catchy title to that. Okay, you need to give a short and, you know, crisp title to that. Next is, you have to share your writing. So you can ask your friends to read and give feedback to you. That's your choice. So these are the five stages of writing. So here in this, picture itself in the right side, I have given the same stages of writing but with few arrow marks. So why this arrow mark is because whenever you start to write something, what happens is you never, you know, come to an end. You never come to a conclusion always on the first part itself. What you will do is you can write pre-writing, drafting, revising, editing. You will be stuck in somewhere because again, if you feel that no, my writing is not proper, again you will go back to revising, or you can go back to drafting, or you can go back to pre-writing so that you can add more details. So this pink arrow marks, you know, it is showing us how does it go. So the first arrow mark directly goes to all the stages. It covers all the stages and it is ending in publishing. But if you see when it is going to drafting, again there are chances that it can go to drafting and pre-writing again. If you feel that drafting doesn't have much points, because whenever you write something, it should have more and more details. One or two lines, that we don't call it as a passage at all, right? So you need to add more details into that. So if you feel your drafting has less number of passages or less number of lines in that sentences, you need to go back to the stage one, that is pre-writing, add more points to it, and then again add it into the drafting part. And once you feel that pre-writing and drafting is done, when you go to the revision part, again you may feel, no, drafting part I have done some mistakes, so let me correct it. So this, it's like a cycle, okay? So till you go for, you are finalized with your editing process, it goes like a cycle. It can go to any stage, you can get stuck in any stage. So it depends upon the way you correct your mistakes, okay? So be sure that you get feedback from other people too, okay? So these were the stages. Now, I'll tell you, this is an example. There are two pictures here. These are two examples of pre-writing. So when any topic is given to you, I told you, you have to think. But thinking, you know, always you cannot make it as a point. Like when you think, it's not necessary that at the same time you're going to write. There are, you know, chances that you miss out few points. Again and again, I'm using that word because that happens. So here in this first picture, there are two topics, cats and dogs. So the child has made a mind map, or you can call it as a brainstorming. So he has made a brainstorming because so that it is easy for him to write. So he has connected two topics together, cats and dogs. So he has just put some words so that when he writes it, it is very easy for him to make it into a sentence. So he has put cats. They clean themselves. They are smart. They catch mice. Okay. And they don't like dogs, and it passes to don't like cats because it is about dogs here. When you go down, there are dogs. It is about dogs. So the child has written dogs don't like cats and cats don't like dogs. Okay. Now, when you describe about a dog, it's fussy. It's, you know, it chases things. It chew things, smart. It can be trained. All this. So all is connected. All are connected together in a form of a brainstorming. So this is the pre-writing. In the next picture, you can see it is about squirrels. So it is about types of squirrels, getting rid of squirrels in garden, how to get rid is you have to put the traps, repellents, ethics of each, red, brown, black flying, these are the types, okay? Then how squirrels nest is same place each year like geese. So with example, the child has supported his details. Now this is how you can write the pre-writing, but this is not only the way to pre-write. Just by putting circles and squares, that is not only the way. It depends upon the genre of writing. For example, last year you have learned six genre of writing: descriptive, persuasive, narrative, creative, expository, and report writing. All these writings have got different pre-writing graphic organizers so that it helps you in pre-writing. So it depends on the topic that you choose. For example, this year in the first unit, who we are learning about persuasive writing. So before you start persuasive writing, directly if you go to the passage, definitely it won't be a proper one. So to avoid your mistakes, what we do is we'll choose the pre-writing as Oreo concept. Okay, the next is, you know, sensory organizer. If your topic, it's like describing something, if you're going to describe about something, definitely you can go for the five senses, that is descriptive writings. This is the mainly used for that, descriptive writing. So this is also called a sensory organizer. And suppose if you think that you want to write a story, for that also there is a pre-writing graphic organizer that is called a story map. So you think of a title, you think of a setting, where it is happening, you think of your characters, what is the problem, what is the solution. So once you jot down your pre-writing, it's very easy for you to make it into a passage. Then correcting, revising, editing, everything will be easy for you. So these are just few examples, and few more examples I will be posting it in the Google Classroom for your reference. So just take a look of these graphic organizers. I'm telling it again, I'm repeating it, that pre-writing graphic organizer depends upon the topic you choose. So for all the types of topics, you cannot write based on the Oreo concept. Because for all the topics, we are not going to give our opinion, right? So it depends upon the topics you choose. So these are the next three stages, that is writing. So how to write a draft? So writing a draft is just you have to, you know, you have to check whether it has got fully developed conclusion is there, the passage is proper, it has got all the topic sentence, body sentence, closing sentence, and it has followed all the rules of writing. So you have to check when you draft something. And they have given you the, you know, difference between revise versus edit. So what is revising and what is editing? So the short form of revise, they have given it in the form of AAMS. So it's nothing but when you are revising, either you can add sentences and words, you can remove words or sentences you don't need. You can move certain words or sentences below or above based on the type it is, whether it is topic, body or closing. And sometimes you can substitute the word. For example, in today's class, when we were discussing about bullying, so you were talking about teasing. Both are same. Teasing and bullying both are same. Okay, so you can replace the word. If you feel that, okay, teasing is a simple word, I can use bullying. That gives more richness to the piece of writing. Definitely you can use it. So substitute words, you can do that. So that's why it's called as AAMS. So A stands for add, R stands for remove, M stands for move, and S stands for substitute. The same way when you come to edit, it's called as CUPS. So what is that? Editing is mainly for checking all those grammar capitalization. So see, capitalize. You have to capitalize name, place, titles, months, and so on. Next, usage. You have to use the parts of the speech very correctly, like noun, adverb, adjective, preposition, interjections, conjunctions, all these things. You have to make it, make a note of it, whether you are using it in the correct format or not. Next is punctuations. This is where I have seen many of you making mistakes, like you never put a full stop there, your sentence just goes on. There is no comma, nothing. So you have to make sure that you are using full stop, comma, everything in a proper place. When there is an exclamatory sentence, exclamation mark is the must. Next is spelling. You need to check your spelling. Even if your spellings are wrong, that's fine, because we are there to edit your works and revise it. Okay, so don't worry about that. But you have to check it. Even though you are doing it, you have to check it. Okay. Next is the last stage is publishing. So once you do the drafting, revising, editing, the last one, everything is correct, perfect, you feel ready. Then what you do is you have to share it with others. So either you can share it by reading it aloud, what you do in the class daily, you read your writings aloud, right? So that everybody else understands what is it, right? That you can do, reading aloud, acting it out. You can act and show. If it is a story, you can act it out and illustrate your story. You can draw, you can picturize it. Okay. And next is post it online. You can post it online. If it is a story, very beautifully written story, you can definitely post it. Or you have done something, you know, fantabulous, like you have described something, you know, you can do that. Then try to get published. This is also a kind of posting it online. Then listen to someone else read it. So once you have written everything, your passage, you can give it to somebody else and you can listen to it, how it sounds when somebody else reads it. So that adds beauty to that passage. So children, writing is a form of an art. So you need to follow all these five stages properly. So hereafter, we will be following these stages. So today we have done the pre-writing and drafting. Once you post back your works to me, what I am going to do is I'll revise and you need to edit it. And some parts I will be editing it. And if I ask you, if I suggest you to add more details, kindly add more details, do the corrections and send the final copy to me through the same task assigned. So I hope you have understood it. You are clear with this. So till I meet you for the next time, take care. Bye. Love you.